Police did, however, find and arrest more than a half dozen gang members this weekend during a sweep of one East Salinas neighborhood. Crackdown took place at one area of town that saw three murders in less than 24 hours last week. Action News reporter Felix Cortez has the story from our Salinas newsroom.
Well, Aaron, that area is Acosta Plaza and Sanborn, which was the focus of several gang-related murders. This weekend, the gangsters were the focus.
Police say they arrested seven gang members in a sweep of Acosta Plaza and the surrounding area. Among those arrested, an illegal immigrant.
A gang member who had previously been deported as a felon and returned illegally to the country was found.
Also picked up was 31-year-old Angelo Perez. Police say he's a paroled gang member who was found with a high-powered assault rifle similar to this.
It has a lot of penetration, can go through many walls, can go through cars. It's a very powerful weapon. This particular one was loaded with 26 rounds of ammunition.
None of those arrested have been charged with any of the three murders that happened in Acosta Plaza and Sanborn last week. Police say the area will continue to get attention. Working with the city attorney, they hope to crack down on those homes that are gang hangouts and declare them a public nuisance.
What that means is we can go in and we can kick the people out and we can board up the house and nobody can inhabit it for a year.
Officer Kelly McMillan said more can be done to crack down on gangs. Just back from a gang conference, he said the city of Oxnard reduced its homicide rate to single digits with the help of local clergy.
That represents a group of people that can get in front of young people without, you know, certainly better than a police officer could and intervene. Do family counseling, things like that. So I think that's a model we should really look strongly at.
While police also hoping to get more federal dollars to help fight local crime, they say Congressman Sam Farr is trying to get more than $2.6 million to help fund the Joint Gang Task Force and the Silver Star Program. That money is currently in the federal omnibus bill, which is making its way through Congress right now. Aaron?
All right, Felix, thank you. So far this year, Salinas has already seen 9 murders.